My name is Joseph Chianese. We're from the Milwaukee, Wisconsin area, and this is my wife, Jeanne Chianese. You know, starting back, what happened is my mother was, I guess you might say bipolar. She made my life miserable, and at the age of 16, she packed my bags. So I struggled a lot. I was broken by what my mother had done to me, and I felt just terrible about myself. I joined the Coast Guard, and this is where, you know, I could say God started coming into my life. I wasn't saved, but he did little things for me. I did very good in the Coast Guard. I was put into aviation school, where I did even better. I found my niche in life finally, and I said, maybe life is turning around for me, you know. I studied real hard, and it gave me a pick of going back to New Jersey, and I was devastated. I go to New Jersey. Under the craziest circumstance, I meet my wife. We got married, and right after that, I had my first symptoms of ulcerative colitis, and it got so bad in the military, they finally gave me a medical discharge. So I get born again, she gets born again.
Separately?
Separately. And you know, the Lord starts coming in our life, and then around that time, we start getting introduced to Kenneth Copeland.
He seemed to address every issue we had in our lives with the Word. And he made us understand that God had integrity and would keep His Word. And so Kenneth Copeland caused us to love the Word and really love God, because we could trust God. He has integrity. He'll keep His Word. He'll keep what He says. He'll do.
I would listen to Kenneth Copeland. I mean, there was many things he did, but the last thing I did to get to healing is I was listening to the tapes until I felt like I was going to climb the walls. But the Lord says, don't stop listening. You got to listen. And you can ask my wife.
Both of us were like, another tape, another tape. We had a lot to get over.
I mean, I was saturated in the Word, and these were all the Kenneth Copeland tapes on healing and things. And I was in work. And you know, with ulcerative colitis, you're running to the bathroom. I was doing every 15 minutes, filling it up with blood. And I was so sick, you know, I was so sick, but I wouldn't let it get to me. And I just kept saying, you know, by His stripes, I'm healed. And then something happened. I can't explain it to you. I went onto a very secluded area. And I said this, and it was the funny thing again, my mind stopped and my heart said this. Jesus, I don't pray this to you. I pray it to the devil. Devil, if you kill me today and show me on my tombstone, died of this date with ulcerative colitis, I will not believe it because, and I screamed it, by His stripes, I am healed. And all of a sudden, for the first time in a year or two, I could go straight up. And I felt like two hands were compressing me, and the heat was tremendous. And all of a sudden, everything left me. I went back to the doctor, and he said I was healed.
Yeah, I was in the waiting room. He had a test to see, you know, how bad it was or whatever. And he said, I'm sorry it took so long. He said, I checked up and I checked down and I went back again because this is not the same. He said, there's no sign that the disease ever was in his body. That's impossible. But we still haven't forgotten the principles. We still listen. We have the MP3 from last year's conference that we play in our room, or we play the Victory Network in our room all night long, because I think as humans, human vessels, we leak. And you got to keep getting filled up with the Word. And we just find that it's such meat. And it just has been such a wonderful meal for over 40 years for us.